Being gay is not about winning. It's about fun.
What's that?
Gay is when you... Gay is like... It's like... It's kind of... Sort of like... What is gay? Let me explain it for you.
G is for God who made us the same. And A is equality.
It's with an E.
Y is for you and me being friends.
Or more if you both agree.
G is for fine when you burn down in hell. A is for a freak show. Y is for no survivors when you're...
Plankton, those things aren't what gay is all about. Now, do it like this.
G is for God who made us the same.
Nonsense! You're a cartoon, you idiot!
Here, let me help you.
G is for God who loves us the same. And A is equality.
Try!
Woo! What's going on, everybody? Old Wild Time back at you again. And yes, I've got to get up here. You know, we got spring ball going on, but Law Tide's gonna get up here and address some fucking trolls that's got nothing better to do than playing their little card games on their little game nights, you know, and do their little, you know, Peter bumping shit that they like to do when they get together, because they ain't no girls that go out there and hang out with them. Hell, besides old Megan, she got bigger dick than all of them, what I hear. But any damn way, shout out to everybody that went to the Slob Olympics. What do you think about it, Carter?
I had a great time. Enjoyed hanging out with you and some of the other guys. Just meeting everybody. You know, Atlanta was it was lively.
Had a great time. Had one of the best birthdays I've had in a long damn time. And thank everybody for acknowledging that. And thank everybody for making this weekend one of the best times. But I do want to get up here and I do want to talk about some things that Law Tide has been thinking about for a little while now. I mean, probably before football season's gotten over. Third Saturday in October, and that's finding out who your real people are. You know, that's finding out who really rides with you and who really is a fence ride motherfucker. You know, and that goes out to these boys out in the mosh pit crew, the damn mosh pit pussy crew that sit online and bump Peters all night, and you know, it has nothing better to do than talk about BBD, and which I don't give a fuck. You can talk about him all you want, and then talk about me, broke me in this bullshit after I done told you a year ago that I don't give a fuck about none of y'all. I could care about any of y'all. Y'all shit on BBD and y'all do all this, but let me tell you something. I've become to realize that BBD don't give a fuck what anybody does for him. He expects that shit, you know? And even when you tell him that, you know, that you're fucking around with the wrong fucking people, he don't give a fuck. He don't care. I mean, it's just like when people get on to him about his smoking and his fucking drinking Coca-Cola's. It just goes one ear and out the fucking other. And that's something Law Tide is very fucking sick of right now. Law Tide is very sick of fence riding motherfuckers. You know, Law Tide wants to mess with people that are cool people, that have good character, that care about people, that don't care about themselves more than they care about people. You know what I'm saying? I've always been one of those that's always, you know, tried to be nice to people when off this son of a bitch. But, you know, when I'm on here, I can be a mean son of a bitch. I can be. I can be very mean. I can be very mean to you too, Carter, you know, sitting at home where you ain't paid a motherfucking bill since you fucking lived there with your fucking mom and stepdaddy. You sit over there, you fucking play on the goddamn internet, you like your fucking 12-year-old. You have little fart games with 60-year-old men.
No. Oh, get the bucket ready.
And you think you're a fucking grown-ass man. And you think you can get up here and dance around like a fat M&M with my face on and think you're something special, son. You ain't never been nothing special. Your trash talking videos back in the day sucked. And you were easy to own. So you had to go get a video that Law Tide hadn't seen in over 13 years. Hell, since Savage Tiger used it years ago. And that's how, and you think I'm going to run from that? I'm not running from you, son. I'm running straight to you, boy. And I'm telling you straight up, you're a fucking punk. You're a little weenie boy. You're a follower of a fucking punk that you, a dude that you ain't ever even met before, that you ain't even broke bread with before, son. And you think you high on the hog with these, all these other boys, and that's toast for you too, Cranges. Hey, Cranges, you know, like I said a long time ago, You know, off this motherfucker, you probably all right. But on this YouTube, you're a follower and you're a fucking dumbass. And, you know, that don't surprise me because you're a fucking Auburn fan. And all Auburn fans I've ever met's got something wrong with them. You know, they've been dropped in the fucking floor a time or two. And, you know, old Hoss, man. Old Hoss, you know, me and Hoss used to be friends. But you want to talk about a friend that's become a fucking enemy. That's me and Hoss right now. And I think that's had something to do with, you know, with y'all telling them, you know, trying to influence that boy and tell him about me and all that shit. But I really don't give a fuck. I don't care. I don't care about you, Hoss. I don't care about you, Carter. I don't give a fuck about you, Cranges. And I sure in the hell don't give a fuck about Unc. Because to me, Unc was the one that poisoned. He's the one that poisoned that group. He's the one that had to, you know, put his little 2 cents in about fucking Uncle Lou and still handle it like a fucking man. Instead of fucking getting it to, you know, instead of not fucking, you know, standing up for himself, he had to go get other motherfuckers to fight his fucking battles for him. And that's just like you, Carter. Just got to have somebody fight the battles for you because you're too fucking pussy to step up to Uncle Lou. Ain't that something? You scared of Uncle Lou because he's got fucking 66,000 fucking followers, subscribers, huh? Is that what it is? And you know, and what he pretty much says is pretty much how it goes on this fucking community. You know, but one thing that me and Uncle Lou have always agreed on is, you know, I've always been a fucking outlaw in this son of a bitch, just like him. And it don't take me no time to get up here and respond to some stupid son of bitches like y'all. And y'all stupid. You know, y'all want to get up here and play your little games, that's fine. But this is the last time, this is the fucking last time that I'll ever address you in a fucking video. So I hope you get as many views over on your bitch-ass channel, you know, where y'all can't even get half the fucking subscribers that I got over there. And y'all have done started how many channels now? That shows you right now you're a failure on YouTube. Y'all have failed the game. And another person that I think has failed the game is what I thought was my best friend to the end, and that's Big Vol Daddy. And you know, I've let Big Vol Daddy use me. I've let Big Vol Daddy, you know, take advantage of Law Tide. You know why? Because maybe I kind of felt sorry for the stupid motherfucker. But when it comes down to it, he don't care about Law Tide. When it comes down to it, he don't care about our friendship. You know why? Because he wants to get over on y'all's fucking channel and tell things about me. And you know, and Fence Ride, you know, and keep this bullshit going. Well, you know what it's done? It's fucking made me want to say, fuck BVD. Fuck all this bullshit on YouTube. And go along and move along. You know what I'm saying? You know, hell, I look on Facebook. I got over 600 followers on Facebook right now. And I hadn't really fucking done anything with that channel. I mean, I could walk away from this motherfucker right now with my head up high and know that I laid down the business. I fucking stood on it for over 14 years and not worry about my legacy on here. I can do that. You know why? Because I've done it. And they can't nobody say I haven't. So if that's the way the game y'all want to play, y'all want Law Tide gone, y'all want Law Tide out of here, then by God, you got it. And you know why? Because I was gone years ago. But I came back for that little fucker up there at fucking Greenville, Tennessee. Yeah, I come back for him. Because he asked me to. But now it's over, son. It's over. Go find somebody else to fucking shit on. Go find somebody else to pick on. Because Law Tide ain't your picking boy no more. When Law Tide shows up at your goddamn house and stomps a mud hole in your fucking ass, you'll fucking know then. And, you know, and y'all are lucky that I'm not that guy anymore. But I can be. Just watch and fucking see. Just like you, Carter, sitting in your fucking uvu rooms, talking your fucking shit, you and your little girlfriend, Unc. You know, you like fucking, you know, putting dicks. Where you like them dicks?
In my mouth.
Oh. That's right. In your fucking mouth. And where the rest of you damn boys like to go? Oh, yeah. Y'all liking pride parades, don't you? You fucking little gay boys. Y'all sit over there, bump each other's peters, and enjoy life. Because that's where Rocco's going. He's going to enjoy life. And he's shutting his bitch down. Today! Y'all have a good one, and I'll holler at you a while ago.
And in my mouth.
Like a little kid's. My dick, large like the Chargers, the whole team. Yo, shit look like you 14. My dick, locked in a cage, right? Yo, dick, suffer from stage fright. My dick, so hot it's stolen.
Yo, dick,
oh.